Thank you to Jessica. Jessica, this is Mark.
He goes back. Don't feel guilty. Jessica, where are you from? Oh, yay!
UK! UK!
Let's get a picture over here. Right over here? Let's pose.
Oh.
I love it. So, Jessica, is this your boyfriend?
Yeah.
And your husband's in the UK? Girlfriend! I have all the pieces you all need to build a tour guide while you're visiting. Do me a favor, if you would, love, push your arms just like so. I'm going to give you all the pieces so you can build a friend. He's like Build-A-Bear, but gross. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hands. That's more fun than your boyfriend. And of course, you're going to have a leg to get around the UK. We have IKEA. A normal, I know it's funny to say, well, with things, but literally, I don't know if the lights did, so don't sniff it, but it's so soft. Just enjoy. She loves it. Would you do me a favor if you would, Alex? Take Jessica over here to the counter. You can just throw this stuff on top.
This is on the
fridge. Yeah. What did you do?
She doesn't trust you at all.
Hey, you want to talk about it there? I'm sorry. Whoever was responsible for that.
We'll never have it again.
Jessica's been initiated. She'll be our lovely assistant. If you could do me a favor, though, sir, roll up your sleeve.
Right.
Folks, you may be wondering where we got all of our severed limbs on the set. I'm going to show you.
Me?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I'm going to show them how we.
I'm your friend. I want you to. What does that mean?
Help me.
Is there somebody else?
Jessica, welcome to America. I will cut her with this big sharp blade. I'll use the smaller one. It'll cut through a tin can and a woman. Oh, you're all so vain. That song was about you. I'm gonna cut it at Jessica Muir, enjoy it, it's gonna look like it hurts. Her job's to make it believe it does by screaming. So, could you give us just for practice like a big UK style scream, like a 1, 2, 3! Actually, yeah, that's a good start. Also, I put something in the emotional deal later, I'm not worried at all. You're doing great. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Whoa, before you cut it, there are kids in the house.
You want me to cut the kids?
Yeah. You should have talked to the kids.
Oh, goodness. Yes. Sweet kids. Listen up. All the blades you're using today on stage are safe, whether they're dull or even made out of plastic. The people who set up the gags are professionals with a lot of training, so whatever you do, don't try this at home.
At your friend's house.
No.
At your grandmother's house.
Dude, no.
Where then?
Church.
Okay. Can we get a close-up on Jessica, please?
Oh, perfect. A scar is born. 1, 2, 3! She's over here! Here we go, check it out! Ta-da! You did great! First of all, the blade is really metal, so it looks shiny and sharp on camera, but it's of course dull. Right behind the handle, there's a big blood bowl. This is filled with fake blood, consisting of corn syrup and food coloring. The blade itself, you can see, looks so obvious from here. But the big secret is that it slides in and out of the handle. So it creates that illusion. So when it's pushed in, this part hidden, we drag it across the arm, this cutaway falls, we pull back quickly. Looks like it's going in. This gag was developed by Tom Savini, very talented makeup artist. Blade is not real, and of course Jessica is only emotionally hard.
Let's hear it, Jessica!
She was a flirt.
Yeah. Notice in the history of makeup artists at Universal, this was way back.
I love this stuff. Goes back to the 1920s, in fact, to makeup pioneer Lon Chaney. Known as the Man of a Thousand Faces, he actually created all of his makeup for classic monsters like Phantom of the Opera, and of course the Hunchback of Notre Dame. Brilliant actor, truly suffered for the art. in Hunchback, he wore a 20-pound hump and this harness that contorted his body so much he could not stand upright while filming. Now, that much we know, but most of this stuff, even today, we kind of have to guess how it was done, because Jamie, like any good magician, was very secretive about his techniques, never told anyone how he did this stuff, took those secrets with him to his grave. But his legacy lived on. Phantom started a horror craze in the 30s, paving the way for many new monsters and makeup artists to go with them, one by the name of Jack Pierce, of whom did the makeup for such famous and well-known monsters like the Wolfman, the Mummy, Bride of Frankenstein, Lady Gaga, and David Hasselhoff. Mayor David Knight, he perfected his creatures by visiting morgues where he would study and experiment on real dead bodies. Boris Karloff played one of my favorites, Frankenstein's monster. That was a hefty combination of rubber, plaster, mortician's wax, and his grease paint they later found out was toxic. 4 hours to apply. It took 8 hours to adhere and dry the layers of cloth, mud, and bandages to Karloff's entire body to turn it into the Mummy. Universal had some great monsters and a few forgettable ones. My favorite said they bring mutant from this island Earth. Come here, Earthwoman! No! Wait! I want to pinch that butt. 1968 came along. John Chambers changed the industry forever, used foam latex in the original Planet of the Apes.
Carl.
If you must know, my car was recently stolen and they left the alarm as a sign of disrespect. Who steals the center?
Why did you put it on the curtain? Why did you just throw it away?
Well, I did it more so as, if I'm being honest, like a joke. I was going to set it off later and say, that was meant for you. But it was.
You think I did it?
Were you the only one? Yes, I do.
I didn't do anything. I was just standing there, and then something hit the curtain.
Okay, I'll go along. But it's what hit the curtain.
A rock.
The wrestler?
No. That's Dwayne Johnson. He doesn't like to be called Rock.
Oh, isn't that true?
Yeah. What happened was him, that boy there, him throwing a rock at the curtain. I don't know why. I think he wants to get out of here. He wanted to ride. So I go straight out of me like this. Now he's an old Italian man.
Dude, is this dirty? Did you throw him rock like an old Italian man? No, he said no. Did you do it in the front? You shoot someone?
Yeah.
He's blaming. What are you blaming? The kid in the front of the gentleman.
He meant to point to him.
No, I pointed at you because you hit.
You meant to
him. Stick. No, him's bigger than me.
Well, what's your name in the front?
Owen,
where are you from?
Wow, he's smart.
He's drinking the butter beer.
Boston.
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 Oh, Boston.
How old are you?
9.
What happened?
I was in Boston. 9 years and 9 months ago. I'm not saying it's him, but...
Is he the same?
He does have my elbows.
Thank God he doesn't have your forehead.
Ever since you moved up yesterday from your clip-on tie, you're so special. With your 72 syllable laugh. All right, I'm gonna let this go because I don't even know what happened. But I'll be watching you. But like in a supportive way, like, yeah, I'll send a check. I'm still talking about before you trash my looks.
Sorry. You were telling everybody about how Planet of the Apes. And they use Playtex on that. That's funny.
For real?
What happened?
Latex. You said latex.
Both are different materials.
Indeed. You're talking about latex and the different ways to bring your creatures alive. Actually, I brought a video of how we use latex in the remake of Wolfman. That's Rick Baker. He did the makeup for the remake of the film. It came out a few years ago. Critics liked it in general, but they really raved about the makeup job. Benicio del Toro played a Wolfman. Now, from the design process of drawing and sculpting, we finally move on to the application, of course. This process, just from the neck up, took 5 hours to complete. Now, that led to the body suits, even crazier in detail, believe it or not. Foam rubber suits had thousands and thousands of gap hairs that had to be individually hand-tied. And leg extensions, like stilts hidden this colossal size and this wolf-like stride, it looked really creepy on the film. Rawr, hey. For Baker, even made edible body parts that El Toro could eat his victims on camera. So cool.
How many times do you rip your hair every night?
7, which is more than any other makeup artist. He recently retired, but he won for Wolfman, he won for Grinch.
Men in Black.
One of my favorites. I even brought a clip of his very first award win, 1981, the first Academy Award ever given for special creature effects, American Werewolf in London. It's funny, it's scary. David Naughton transforms in front of our very eyes into American Werewolf in London. It still looks really good. No computer effects, no camera tricks, no stop-motion animation. Looked like that on the set.
It's a great movie. If you've never seen it, watch it. It's great. When you're watching the movie, the world is growing. You don't see a lot of editing. How was that accomplished 35 years ago?
Check it out over there, these little mysterious red mountains. We actually were able to procure these from the movie. By procure, I mean word of the day that I'm trying to work into the show. But you can see here, instead of the actor under the makeup, it was a fiber.